Okay, guys, I am back. Yes, I am back. I've had a few rest days. I still came in and had some cardio sessions, though. Cardio is definitely a necessity for me because I clearly am trying to stay on track of the goals, just trying to make sure that I'm still hitting the necessary calorie output so that I can actually keep on top of the shred. At the end of the day, I think I did a pretty good job on those days off. I even went to the sauna most days as well to take care of those general health, well-being kind of aspects, and also to further, I guess, improve some weight loss aspects as well. Either way, those rest days did me some good. I actually feel a lot better now. My knee is, it's still a little niggly, but it's a lot better. My lower back, same thing. Things have definitely improved and I feel a lot more refreshed, which is definitely a necessary thing for me. You know, that's the thing, is that I'm probably, like I said before the break, I'm going to consider actually having two rest days per week, because it's kind of necessary when you're in a calorie deficit. You know, revving your training up while on less fuel is not necessarily the best recipe for success. Sometimes it can be a recipe for disaster, and you can actually end up burning yourself out or even injuring yourself. So I'll have to weigh that one up. I might drop a day out so it's two rest days per week. I may keep it at one rest day a week. We'll see how we go over the next couple of days. Either way, it's leg day today. Not a great one for me to want to start on, but it's a necessary one for me to start on. So with it, we're probably just going to be doing some warm-ups in the functional area first, and then after everything's been nice and warmed up, we'll smash out, I'm thinking, pendulum squat today, and then finishing on those isolates and smashing some calves at the end. Either way, that's the plan for today. We'll see how we go. Let's get stuck in. Oh, how deep. So to do a bit of a warm-up for me, what I thought, I could go upstairs and do some band work. The hip abduction and adduction machine, this bad boy, is free. I thought I'd start on here just to warm up the hips a little bit more. I do very much think that warming up your hips is a damn near imperative thing to do in the gym when you're training legs and you actually want some serious gains. The thing about the human body, it is a system. It is a network of all kinds of stuff, but let's talk about the skeletal muscular system. All the muscles are more or less intertwined. In fact, something that we learned in uni, not in my exercise sports science degree, ironically, but in my myotherapy degree, we're talking about fascial trains. And we're talking about these different train lines, they call them, of how certain muscles are interconnected. And there's six or eight different ones, I believe. And what happens is you'll actually find that they all pull on each other. I mean, you know, we mainly learnt them for figuring out issues in terms of if one's having an issue with a trigger point, then maybe something down the track is on that train, at that fascial line. So either way, the thing is that if that muscle is not being anchored in properly by another muscle that's connected by I guess before it, and all towards the core as well. That's what I believe, is that all muscles peripherally, so out here, all pull in towards the core. So if your core isn't strong and anchored, that's why having a powerful core is important. And when I say core, I don't mean just your abs. I mean your abs, your back muscles like your erectors and your QLs and such. And then also your glutes and hip flexors. I believe that is your core. Well, that's what I mean when I say core, at least. So if your core muscles, your base structure muscles aren't strong and conditioned, when you do anything, bicep curl, hamstring curl, leg extension, damn calf raise, I don't know, you name it, anything that's got a muscle that's pulling into the body, you're not gonna be able to maximize its contraction if you don't improve its core, anchor, I guess you can call it. What it anchors to the pull. You know, like my bicep couldn't do a really good job if my shoulder muscles weren't anchoring correctly. And for those to anchor correctly, I need my body to feel nice and strong. That means my pec and my back muscles and all of those won't be strong either if my core isn't on to hold myself upright and in a stiff, strong position. So that's what I mean by that. Either way, turn your core muscles on, and that includes, if you're gonna train lower body especially, your hip muscles. So I'm gonna be hitting my glutes with this bad boy as well as my adductors. So abductors and adductors. A whole range of muscles there. Either way, let's get stuck in. Just gonna be doing maybe two sets of each, and that should be enough. And then I may still do some band stuff before we jump in to do our main exercises of the day. Okay, let's do it. I'm just gonna zoom out a smidgerini. Let's zoom it out. Good. Yeah, there we go. Okay, let's go. That's too light. Oh. Also, I thought I'd mention, I did have a trim, which is nice. It's actually refreshing to have. The issue with that is that I look like an idiot wearing a hat with no long hair. I look like I'm bald. So I forgot to wear my hat today, actually. So I've got this microphone sitting here. Sorry if it sounds a bit muffled. If it is really muffly when I edit this, then I'm gonna wear a hat anyway, even if I look a bit bald. Okay. So that was abduction, our knees going away. Now we're doing adduction, adding our legs together. That's how I like to remember that one. Nice. So I'll do one more set of those, and then either pendulum squat, or we may actually go over to the glute bridge machine and punch out just three sets of three plates on that or something like that, just to kind of get the glute stimulated, because I do want to make sure that they're nice and plump for when I am shredded, so that they look good on the stage. You know, I believe that there are certain muscles on the human body, the male body, that are very underestimated when it comes to looking stupidly strong and fit, especially when you're shredded naked or in your, you know, your stage posing underwears. And more or less, that's, glutes are definitely one of them. You know, a lot of people think glutes are the chick muscle, you know? It's for chicks that want a big badonkadonk so they can get some great Instagram snaps. That is wrong. It's for everyone. If you're a dude and you're not chasing some glute gains, I'm sorry, I'm gonna hate to break it to you, but you're gonna be stunting your growth, not just functionally, because it is incredibly functional. My God, your glutes are so important to lower chances of back injury, because if you don't have strong glutes when you're doing hip extension, you're gonna be using your lower back predominantly, and then that's where you have back issues. So, but apart from functionally, you know, if you don't have a good set of glutes as a male, then when you are shredded, you're not gonna have this full figured physique that looks like a superhero or an athletic. Look at people who sprint, because they naturally have very developed leg muscles. When you're a sprinter and you're lean, holy shit, look at those legs. They look sick. They just look good. So, you know, don't sleep on glutes, guys. Okay, one more set of this. It's interesting, you may find that when you're firing off on this bad boy, that all your glute fibers aren't firing off evenly or fairly. If that's the case, you may need to do some, you know, isolated, like really, you know, fine-tuning glute work with light weights that really feel for that area. Or you may also need to do some remedial work and actually get some knots ironed out or something of the such. So do keep that in mind, guys. You actually do want both glutes firing off symmetrically and all fibers. All of them, there's a shitload of fibers in those glutes. Oh. Okay, adductors. I like to go pretty wide with adductors, guys, and then kind of just pull them in as I sit down, because you do want to get some great stretch, because I want to be strong and functional in a as large a range of motion as possible when I'm training my legs or any other muscle, really. Nice. Okay, we're done with that. Let's head on over to whatever we've got next on the cards. Ooh. Okay, let's get to booty burning. So we've got three plates on each side now. I did a two-plater just before on each side just to kind of make sure that I was feeling the action properly. It is never a good idea to jump straight into an exercise that especially is a compound that you're trying to go heavy on, without doing a feeler set or warm-up set, whatever you want to call it, first. At least one, Jesus. But if you're not going to be doing at least one of those, you're setting yourself up for some danger or shitty reps and execution. You know, not too many people are stupidly good at an exercise that they can just jump straight on in, heavy as shit. And even with a bit of a warm-up that wasn't that exercise, and then just smash it out. I always, always do, when I'm gonna go heavy, a feeler work-up set before I go crazy on it. It's mainly just to make sure that you get great mind-muscle connection, you're executing form properly before you jump in, and that you're recruiting the proper targeted muscles instead of compensatory muscles, and also, you know, to warm up the area and so on and so forth. It's for injury prevention and maximizing gains. So don't sleep on that. Okay, let's just punch out about 15 of these, get the booty burning, and do a couple more sets. Nice and easy. You know, I should go up, but I felt that more on my left glute than my right glute. So, you know, that's the thing is, I could go up, I could smash that out and get another set of 15 at four plates, or I can actually choose to do the smart thing when it comes to bodybuilding and just keep it at the same weight and do my damn best to make sure that I feel it in both glutes as evenly as possible. And that's what I'm gonna do. Next set after that, if I succeed in making sure both glutes got the same amount of burn and stimulation, I'll then chuck it up and we'll try to get the same effect on the four plates. And then we'll probably end it there and then head on over to do our main compound of the day, which is pendulum probably, and then some isolates. But yeah, that one, yeah, I don't know. It just felt a little bit more left glute dominant. But my left glute is my more dominant glute, so. You know, it's naturally going to want to try and take over. So we've just got to sit there and use a bit of mind muscle magic to kind of drive it into that right glute a little bit more. Okay, let's have a rest. Oh, I've got the craziest ray of light on this machine, as you can see. Holy glute gains, here we come. Okay. So again, really need to try and feel this in my right glute a little bit more. Oh. Okay, here we go. That light is friggin' hot. That felt a lot more even. It actually made it feel a fair bit easier too, which is a good sign. So let's go up, let's add another plate on each side. Boy, oh boy. Hopefully this doesn't sound absolutely shithouse sitting here. I don't know. I reckon next time I train, it's gonna have to be wearing a hat. Yeah, because last time I did this, it sounded like I was speaking through my hand. And I don't want that. I want you guys to be able to hear what I'm saying, as much as you probably don't care. Okay, enough yammering. Procrastinating. Stop it. Let's get it done. Ooh. Ooh, boy, definitely felt that a bit more. Oh yeah, they're definitely nice, tight and firing. Okay, we're done with some pre-activate-y stuff, bit of a first compound as well. Probably not gonna go stupid with the pendulums or whatever I'm planning on doing, but I definitely wanna feel my legs burn a bit, so probably more volumey, if anything, and just really getting some nice range of motion and getting that muscle squeezed. Okay, let's move along. So yeah, we're gonna be doing some pendulum. I've just got a single plate on here at the moment. Just gonna try and smash out a whole bunch, probably something like 30, to try to get the leg burn happening. Weirdly enough, if I go a bit heavier and I'm pushing on this one, I feel it in my knees. But if I go a bit lighter and go for volume, I actually get it a little bit in my hamstrings and glutes, weirdly enough. So we're gonna be trying to punch for that because I want better hamstring tie-ins, especially towards the glutes. So we'll see how we go. Let's punch out 30, get it done, and try to catch my breath after. Oh. Okay, you know what? I think that was only like 20, which is super disappointing. And it's weird because I'm puffing, but I'm not gassed. So it wasn't that really got me. It's that lingering sciatic tired feeling in my right hip region. It's kind of shooting into my lower back and down into my pelvis. It's a weird feeling. It kind of makes me feel hell weak. It feels like it's fatiguing that side so much faster. That's all right. It is what it is. What I might do, I might just switch it over to the leg press and punch out, I don't know, 15 to 20 reps of like 4 to 6 plates on each side. You know, my knee's a bit funky and I don't think I brought my wraps today. But it's okay. I'm pretty happy with the amount of stuff that I've done so far. Especially because we're gonna finish nice and strong on the isolates. And I'm pretty sure I will finish quite strong on those, which is great. And then some carbies. Either way, let's not linger. Let's get it done. Oh. Okay, so we're here on the leg press, got 4 plates on each side. We're gonna see how we go. Been giving it some thought onto why my back is feeling as garbage as it is lately. I think there's probably a couple things I could be doing to improve my lower back structural integrity in terms of how it feels kind of unstable. It feels like there's a few muscles in there that aren't firing off the way they should, which would improve neural response, so better nerve activation, and also stop my nerves from firing off in like negative ways, like that sciatic pain. And those things would be stretching more. I think I need to stretch more. That is one of those things where I've been really shit. And I believe if you're a bodybuilder of any kind, then you definitely should not be dodging out on your stretching and functional work. It's definitely something that I've been pretty bad at keeping on top of, but it's something that, you know, that's why doing these kind of things are actually really, really good. You know, doing comp preps and all these things where you put your body in some pretty tough positions, because you end up finding out a lot of problems that you've got. And obviously my biggest weaknesses are my knees, my left knee specific, and my lower back specifically, my right side. So it's a bit of a shitty shift there. Probably feeding off each other, to be honest. As that's usually how it goes, which is doing it, I'm not sure. But I think my knee is from my ankle because I've got limited mobility in my ankle and that's causing a hip shift, which is now taxing my lower back. So it's usually all interconnected. But again, what I could be doing is going upstairs into the functional room here at Silverback's Strength Bendigo
and smashing out some stretching, remedial work, a bit of functional work, pre-activators, so on and so forth, to really improve those weaker muscles that aren't firing off. I have suspicions that I've got some muscles that are on my lower back, upper glute tie-in area that are just in front of or around my SIJ joint, and they're just not firing off properly. So there's some work there that I could be doing to improve that. And if you're experiencing some issues around those kind of things, maybe not necessarily in the hips or lower back, but other areas, you really need to take notice of it, address it, sort it all out. There is usually a way to fix just about anything and everything, as long as it's not a broken bone, a severed nerve, a permanent damage like injury. There's a lot of things that you think are permanent, but you'd be surprised. If it's soft tissue that hasn't been nerve damaged or broken with bone structure, you could probably fix it. It's crazy shit. Nerves and bone are a bit different. Bone can be temporary as well, but nerves, not so much. Okay, so I'm gonna get stuck into this. We can talk more after that, but it's enough yammering. Let's get this set done. So with this one, I'm just gonna go really nice, slow and controlled to make sure that everything's firing off that I want to fire off. Because this knee here isn't firing off perfectly. And that's not what we want. Okay, not too bad. I definitely felt that in my knees. Felt a bit garbage, but my knee, my left knee. It's just, I don't know if you can see it, it's in this area. Just on the side and below of my patella tendon, or patella kneecap. So, at the end of the day, just gonna be smashing this out, nice and controlled. As the shred is going, I'm seeing a bit more and more of how my legs are shaping up. For having the kind of setbacks I've got with injuries in my knee and lower back, I'm not completely upset with how everything's looking. It could definitely be better, let's be honest. But it's not doing too shabby. I think what's really helping with a lot of that is the fact that I'm just not giving up, that I'm still trying to smash out my 2 leg days per week, that I'm still coming to the gym and feeding it some decent stimulation on a regular basis and still fueling my body, still getting in the recovery. I think that's paramount, guys. Look, it's very rare that you're gonna be one of those people that do something like a very long gym journey and never have an injury, especially one that lingers, which, you know, most of us do, sadly. And I'll be honest with you, which I've definitely been, because I've been a whingy bitch about it a little bit. My bad, but my knee and my lower back. Shoulder issues, sure, but they're something I can manage and they've been there forever and I just don't even think about them anymore. But my knees, they're actively painful when I try to use them, so it kind of hits me in the face a little bit more. But look, you know, like, if there's something that I can at least try to help people with, is that showing them that you can do it, even with some injuries, setbacks, pains, niggles, inabilities, you know, you can push through it. I'm hoping that by the end of this comp prep, I can scrub up looking pretty good. And then hopefully I can show you that not everyone has a perfect prep, yet they can still scrub up pretty good, which can hopefully help a lot of people that are in the comp prep phase of their bodybuilding journey, if they're doing bodybuilding, and have hitting some walls and thinking, fuck, should I just give up? I don't think I can do it, blah, 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 blah. You know, I'm hoping that as much of a whinger I have been at points, that I can sit there and hopefully, fingers crossed, I can pull this off, you know, continue with my diet as planned, recover, train hard everywhere else that I can, keep on top of what I can with my knees and lower back, and then scrub up good enough that makes people go, holy shit, if he can do it, I can too. You know, that's the thing, is that I'd love that. I'd love it so that I can kind of be a bit of motivation and a bit of an example of why, you know, you just don't give up on yourself. And, you know, put in the hard work and you can get there. And this sucks, don't get me wrong, trying to push through pain, not burning sensations, not, you know, of the muscle, not working DOMS, that lactic acid burn, none of that, you know, it hurts, but it's kind of good feedback. the actual structural pain. That stuff's different because your body's like, I want to stop to save you, and you're kind of having to fight against it. Obviously, you know, if it gets that bad, you should probably stop because it's probably telling you you're breaking. But you know, you're gonna have like a little bit of inflammation, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bit of problems that you're gonna be having along the way. And you could just give up and not try anymore and just, you know, say goodbye to your legs or whatever you wanna do. But in the end, if you, you know, if you fight through it and you're not an idiot with it, and you, you know, do everything you can around it, you know, feed the body, fuel it, micronutrients, recovery, you know, all that kind of stuff, remedial work, and then try to also target the problem behind it. If you can do all that, I don't think you're gonna have a permanent injury, which would suggest then, if you're not gonna have a permanent problem by persisting, then you should just, you know, walk on the coals, get it done. You know, feel the burn, but it's only gonna be temporary, and the outcome is gonna be a significant difference. So don't do that to yourself. Don't give up on yourself, basically. Push through it. Okay, that's my little motivational rant. That was, you know, probably long-winded, done. Let's get another set done, guys. You know you talk too much when you can talk through a whole rest period. Okay. It's funny how that first set makes things feel a lot better. Still feel shit here, but it is what it is. Okay. Whew. So that's the thing. It's not heavy. You know, I could obviously keep doing a bit more, but I'm just trying to get the muscles feeling it and to really get some action happening in my vastus heads, being those three heads that pop up into your knee. You know, it's a quad, so there's four muscles, but your vastus heads, there's three. You got your vastus lateralis, which is on the outside, vastus intermedialis on the middle, and VMO, which is vastus medialis oblique. So lateralis, intermedialis. Sorry, I got distracted. Vastus medialis oblique, VMO. You've also got your intermedialis, which is a vastus head, but it's not one that pops up near the knee, so I wasn't gonna mention it. Either way, we're gonna do one more of those and then smash out some isolates, try to fit in some carby boys, and then disappear because I'm gonna try and make it to the sauna tonight. I've been getting in a good rut with that over the last couple of days. Cardio sauna, smashing it out. And now that we're back into the gym, I don't wanna stop. I've got 14 weeks, roughly, to shred to the bone. Or, you know, maybe less. I'm gonna be honest, possibly less. 11, 12, I actually can't remember. It's probably less. We'll see. But I'm gonna have a look at the calendar again. Whoops. But yeah, let's just say I've got 12-ish weeks to shred to the bone. And I don't wanna fuck that up. Okay, one more set. I'm gonna smidge of rest. Let's get this last set done. And then we can just smash them out. Isolates and get the hell out of here. Okay, just finished on a nice 30. Just in case. Okay, so with that one done, just smash a few little isolates after this. Pretty quick, honestly, but yeah, nothing crazy. Maybe just some hamstrings. I'll do a quick little circuit set. Hamstrings, quads, and just some carbies. Okay, let's get it done. Oh, okie dokie. So, I got a little bit caught up in a chin wag. to your surprise. Okay. But that's the thing about the gym. You meet some pretty cool, interesting people. It's hard to, you know, this is like my main social aspect of my life. I know I shouldn't use that as an excuse. I'm mid-comp prep, but you know, while I've got like 12 or 14 or whatever many weeks I've got, you know, sometimes I get a little bit sidetracked. Okay, either way, let's not talk much more because I am running late.
I've got it on 130. We're gonna go up. We're gonna do at least 3 working sets of this bad boy. Now, the quad extension machine that I usually use is being reupholstered, so we're not looking good for quads today. There is another one, but it is being used and abused by other people, so I might have to skip out on quad extensions today, which is kind of shit, but I will admit, my kneecap is feeling dog shit. Look, in hindsight, I know why. The other day, I decided to do a sprint on the treadmill, and it did not like that one bit. I should have done it on something like an elliptical or a bike where there is no impact, but I'm a heavy boy, and whenever I run, I tend to run with a stomp, and I think that was not a pleasant thing for my knee. It didn't actually hurt while I was doing it. It felt great, but then literally when I got in the car after it, I was like, holy shit, it's inflamed. Either way, that's me whinging more. Let's get this done. Rawr. I also really should have done my isolates before my compounds. That seems to be a pretty positive thing for me. If I do them before, it seems to wake up my legs appropriately and get anything that's not firing off properly firing off. Because that first set, X rep, just felt garbage, but now it's already starting to feel better. Oh. Okay, good. We're done with that. I have the shittiest feeling in the back of my knee now. What is going on? Damn it. Okay. That has been a thing in the, ooh, there is a trigger point right there. Maybe I found it. Oh, I'll attack it a little bit and then we'll get stuck into another set. Yes, I got chin wagged again. I'm a naughty boy. Okay. Let's up it to 150. Let's get it done. 15 reps. Oh, that could be tighter. Oh, that's actually pretty good. Let's do it. Oh, excellent. So I rolled out my calf just a tiny bit, and that's actually helped. Could have done it a bit more though, I think, but I was on the right track. Just gonna do an extra 5. 1. Nice. Okay, one more set and we done, because I'm running out of time. So, last set, let's just bump it up to 170 and smash it out. Actually, yeah, best not to go too crazy. I did have a bit of a rest. Okay, lock the legs in. Okay, here we go. I should have gone heavier. Oh, well. And 20, that was actually really good. Definitely should have started with the isolates today, guys, because they feel so much better. My knees, everything. Oh well, you live, you learn. Next session, that's what we'll be doing. Isolates first, compound second. Either way, guys, that's a wrap. I've got to bounce, I'm actually running really late, but I'll leave you guys to it. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for next sesh. Stay sweaty, swole, shredded, and all that other stuff, but most of all, stay tuned, and I'll see you guys next time. Always squeeze the juice.